Welcome back. Well, let's address Z Entertainment and the kind of recovery we've seen intraday. We have Abneesh Roy of Edelweiss Securities who's joining in to discuss more on that. Abneesh, hi. Thank you very much for taking the time out. I know you have a call to get to soon, but if you could just tell us what kind of investor queries you've been fielding all morning on Z.
I think initially the stock was down because people were worried that is it because of the group level debt levels, is that the primary reason? But I think the main reason is also that technology upgradation will happen, the reach expansion will happen more in the international geographies. I think both reasons are there, but the bigger reason in my view will be the tie-up with a strategic player. Now, the key questions which I think investors have is in terms of the timeline, 4-5 months, is that enough? Which partner will be better? For example, Amazon, Google, Alibaba, Comcast, all the names are there. So which one will have a better tie-up for Z from both technology and reach perspective? So I think company as such is doing amazingly well. If you see 150 bips gain in market share in the Indian GEC, clearly the number one in the entertainment, right, GEC, X or sports.
Abneesh, would you imagine that when they make an announcement like this, they would already have shortlisted some suitors? Maybe things already are at a slightly advanced stage than what the press release suggests?
No, I don't think so. I think this will take time. They will be evaluating. This is the initial stage of this entire process. No, so I think this will take time.
But Abneesh, Z is anyway very cash rich, right? It has a very strong balance sheet, if I'm not mistaken.
Absolutely. It's a very strong balance sheet, for strong cash flow. Broadcasting doesn't need much of a capex. So this entire thing, if you see, it's a promoter stake sale. Mm. So it is that Z promoters will be giving their stake up to 50% to a strategic partner. So not on the funds are unlikely to come into the company in a meaningful way.
Abneesh,
to be part of the deal.
A promoter selling stake in such a cash rich company, in such a well run company, doesn't it seem a little odd? Couldn't the guys who are executing so well now have transitioned with content tie ups and things like that instead of selling stake? I mean, my question is, does this at least in some way seem like a back to the wall kind of deal? You began by saying there were concerns about the group level debt, etc. Couldn't it be that, and what implications will it have if that is indeed the case?
No, I think clearly there are other divestment opportunities available for the group. We have seen in the past few weeks earlier, there was one more divestment by the group, not in the Z listed entity level. So I think, yes, it's a confluence of both the things. This was a surprise to us and to the markets, and that's why if you see, initially it did correct. But there are other investments, divestments, which are possible. It's not that they have to do this in a rush, and they will do this with a strategic player, which will help the business from medium to long-term perspective. Mm.
So you're okay with any sort of diversification?
No, I think clearly the name matters. So if it is someone like a Comcast or an Apple or a Google, I think clearly that will be seen as a positive because those will be able to add value to the business, especially on the Z5 and on the international part of the business.
Any sort of FDI kind of issues here in the sector?
No, limits? Not at all.
No, nothing.
Not at all. In broadcasting, that's not the issue. It will be in the news space, not in the Z Entertainment.
And any, you already mentioned a long list of names, some of the FANG names, etc. So that's what's doing the rounds, Abneesh, is it? In the market?
Yes, so these are the key international names who have already big interest in India, big interest in media, indirectly, directly. So yes, these will be the names which will be part of the list. As I said, currently it's in the initial parts of the discussion, so it's nowhere near a final stage. But yes, these will be the key names. These will add value to the business, and these will be the strategic players.
Okay. All right, Abneesh. Well, we don't have much time to go to understand what the promoter's intent would be for Z Entertainment. There's an investor call, which is at noon. But with that, it's also a wrap on the show. We're going to leave you with some F&O trading strategies. Stay tuned. Halftime Report is up next, and we have the WPI numbers as well.